You're a crossword.
Please come here. Thank
you. May I take this opportunity to share with you a few words about our chief guest this evening? Ravina Tandon has not just portrayed impactful and memorable characters in a career spanning over two decades, but she has also been at the forefront of many noble causes related to women's welfare and empowerment. Truly, she stands as an inspiration to women and has been part of various prestigious conclaves, panels and NGOs, thereby helping them to create more awareness related to the safety and education of women. Recently, she's the recipient of the award from the Women and Child Ministry of India for her work for women empowerment. Congratulations, Ravina, and all the very best for many more ventures in the future. I now would like to invite and hand it over to our chief guest joining us this evening, gracing the occasion. Ravina, thank you so much. And we've been discussing everything about the making of the book and, of course, women empowerment and resilience. So what do you do? Share a few words with us this evening.
First and foremost, when you say chief guest, you put too much pressure on me, dude. let's take it from the fact that I was one of those few lucky ones who got Who is Revathi Roy, an advanced copy. And I must say that it's an honor that I'm sitting amongst two very powerful women. May the force be with you. How many of you can identify with that? But when I went through the book, I think what is extraordinary about Who is Revathi Roy is the honesty in the book. Besides the fact that it's a very honestly written book, it is something that I think a lot of us women will identify with. I was so proud to read about her journey as a woman, as a mother, as a wife, as a daughter-in-law, and above all, a contributor to our society. And I say that because every success story is great, right? I mean, everyone works hard, everyone achieves success, and they have a story of their own to tell. But what makes it all the more extraordinary is when you pick yourself up and walk again. These are things which I find very extraordinary in women who have faced circumstances which sometimes get them to the lowest low of their lives. And when they fight against that, against all odds, and then make it a complete success story is what makes it completely marvelous. And for me, that really touched me somewhere because I actually identified a lot with you, Revathi, in this, because I myself went through a phase in my life where professionally, personally, I was on a complete zero. And I can't say life circumstances, but it was pretty self-inflicted as well. And I had to restart my career all over again. And one thing that stayed in my mind, which I will quote my dad, my father, Ravi Tandon, he always told me that when a child learns how to walk, he falls many times. But he has to pick himself up and learn to walk. And when he learns to walk, he walks high with his head held high like a man. And that is something that stuck by me, that yes, I have fallen. Fine, I have fallen. But I have to pick myself up and I have to walk again because I'm not going to keep lying down. No one can get me to keep lying down because I am going to walk again. And that is the spirit which really touched me through the book. And I congratulate you on that. And another thing that I did find is her very bubbly, effervescence kind of a persona, which I completely love. I used to tell people when they say, you know, you're always smiling through everything and what happens, don't you feel sad? We've never seen you without a smile on your face. And I used to tell people, you know, I actually laugh the loudest when I'm my saddest. I mean, that's a very strange thing, but that's how I bring it out. And that is something, another thing that I saw in her personality throughout. I think even Saurabh mentioned that just now. And I did find that, and that's another thing that completely shines through. So this is a book completely after my heart. I would request everyone to read it. I would request a lot of women to read it because this just shows you completely that you can never, never let anyone, anything or any circumstance get you down in life. So thank you so much for having me here. It's indeed an honor for me to be sharing the stage with you and you, ma'am. I mean, congratulations to both of you and all your fields of work. I think so too. I think it's a very honestly written book. It's a great job done by Swati, and obviously she has, reflected completely on, Revati's life. And what I do feel is, it is a read not only for the fact that it's an extraordinary successful life, but it is extraordinary beyond the kind of difficult circumstances that women have to rise through and shine through, and the fact that she's given back to society. It's not only that she's accumulated success for herself and laurels for herself, she's given back to society, and that I think is one very important message that should go through. I think that is why I said that I completely identify with Revati's book, because it is something that you have to overcome, that you have to talk to yourself within. There is a very nice paragraph in her book where she reflects, and when her husband passes away, and she's sitting and she actually thinks that her life is blank, and she says, it's like an introspection where you think that no, I've got to do this, and it's not only for me, but I'm doing it for also all those women who are working for me. It is my dream, it's my vision. She said her husband was her eyesight, but that was her vision. And that is something that thought has to come to you, that awakening has to come within you. And you have to recognize your own inner Shakti. I believe that all us women have some kind of a Shakti, and that's why we were probably worshipped at Devis, because there's something extraordinary amongst all of us. How we recognize it, when we recognize it, and how we choose to bring that energy out is up to us. It's all in our hands. We don't need anyone to do that for us. It's all within us. So it's very important for us to recognize the fact, recognize our Shakti, and bring it out in the open. Jab se main 4-5 saal ki thi, always. Books is a very integral part of my life. I love reading and I read really fast. I read this book in 3 hours flat. I couldn't put it down. I did. Bang, it just went on. So I love reading, and especially when there are inspirational stories like this, it's a complete not put down. They offend women somewhere. Well, women are put down in a lot of times, and I think it's unfortunately it's those kind of media journalists only who try to portray that actresses are not beyond anything, but not beyond Bollywood. Well, we are everything that a woman is. We are enterprising, we are, most of the women in our industry, especially actresses, are even running their own production houses. They are writing scripts, they are doing everything. They are moms, they are wives, they are daughters, they are daughter-in-laws. And we multitask all the time. And yes, above all, we are a citizen of this country, this magnificent, beautiful country of mine. And I also own each portion of this land, and what happens in this country matters to me as well, because I have my children and I foresee a future for this country. I have every right to comment on whatever that happens in this country within. So no one can take that constitutional right away from me to speak if I want to speak about my country. Right? She's so bubbly and so, I love her laughter. It's so contagious. I hope if I ever get a chance to play her that I'll be able to portray what she is. Absolutely. I think she's a little softer than me though. Main to lad padti hu. Ye bichari ye soft but strong power hai.
Ma'am, aapko thoda sikha dege.
Soft banna, I need that. I think from everyone on this table, we'll say one line for Mother's Day.
Okay.
आपने तो देखा ही, she doesn't need an introduction. I think she wins the Mother of the Century Award from my side.
Thank you.
I think for my mother, I would like to say that she's taught me strength. She's taught me how to be resilient. and she's taught me how to do it in a very beautiful, graceful manner. And above all, like I told you, my dad always taught me to rise, in any situation. But it's my mother who taught me how to be grounded, and I think she taught me compassion, and that I think is very, very important. Thank you.
Thank you.